How's that? Is that still? Is that too flickery? Yay. Is that too flickery, or is it okay? I'll try the other one. Hang on a minute.
Yeah, that is very flickery, isn't it? Try that one. I'll just move that. It's not great, but tolerable. We'll try this one. It's.
What's that one like? That's less flickery. Okay, we'll go for the non-flickering state.
We'll go for the non-flickering state.
Yeah, okay, this picture keeps a bit more still, so we'll just do that. Brilliant, well, welcome everybody. Have the feet shoulder width apart. Just check, yeah, you can see my hands and feet. So I've got some new stuff today that we're going to look at. And just very gently sink the hips.
Just let me move these out of the way of the... Move that closer, actually, because that will pick up my sound. Move that. Let's have a look. Oh.
You want this one? That's a better sound. That's a better sound. Okay, great. We are sorted. So nice and tall, relax the elbows. Relax around the hands and feet. Take soft, gentle breaths. Just gently breathe in and out. So you want to sink the hips, you want to lengthen through the spine. Relax around the hips, relax around the knees and the ankles. Relax the shoulders, the elbows, and the wrists. Turn. Just let the arms fall. Keep breathing. Very good. She swears by it. So get the non-alcoholic, because obviously, you know, animals probably don't drink that much alcohol. So so just feel that you're nice and relaxed here. I needed a nice hall to do my Zoom classes from, because I could use my friend's house, but the problem is you're in their house, and then if they've got the grandkids around, that's not going to work. It has to be something I can use every week.
Really quiet.
That's quiet, yeah. Which is really lovely and quiet, this hall, it's beautiful. It's only been running about 3 weeks or something. So So we're sinking our heads while we're chin-wagging in this hall.
Yeah.
we're nice and tall. So, I've been taught some absolutely horrible leg exercises. Yay, horrible leg exercises.
Yeah.
So that was I spent 3 hours with my teachers yesterday. It was fantastic. I loved it. It was brilliant. Oh, it was wonderful. So
we're getting microscopes in there, are we?
Yeah. So I learned some very useful stuff off Eva. She's very good. I've got some new silk reading, and I'm going to try and do that here because I think I almost got it. I almost got it. So, and it's really good for the brain. I'm trying to see them 3 hours a week now, my teachers, on a Tuesday. It's very good if I get a chance. So we're all breathing, all nice and relaxed. Yeah, I've just found out I've got the afternoon off.
Ooh.
So I don't need to go
crazy.
Yeah. Are you in, after we finish, are you in a hurry to
do something?
Yeah, I need you to film me moving about to some music for a video.
Yeah.
Awesome. Because it's Jan Wu, because I want to do Jan Wu here anyway, so it's just something, it's the spontaneous movement that you do. It is. No, the care home that I'm at, they're not having any visitors today.
Oh.
So I guess something
kicked off
or there's a bug. I'd rather they kept it to themselves, actually.
Yeah.
Now people are mixing a lot more, you know.
You're catching everything now.
Catching everything now,
yeah. You always had anything, now we're getting everything.
Yeah. So feel the ground under your feet. And we're nice and tall. And just practice your sleepy tiger eye gaze. And we've been doing the Bajuan Jin, I think, in this class as well. So we'll have another look at that. So we'll just bounce.
I wouldn't want to do the 18 steps.
You want to do the 18, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
That goes for the zoomies as well. What I do in this class is a little bit more free-form. So there's some of working a specific thing. This is sort of working general, anything that's good for you. So it means we've got a little bit of flexibility as to what we cover. So if there's a move you really, really like that's your favourite, we can cover it. If you like write it in the chat or you say, I would like to do the 18. And then we shake. Oh. So I'll be learning the second 18 from May. So I'll be able to start teaching that. Very excited about it. And then the 10th of March, I'm learning a new Qigong, Yang style Qigong. So I'll be learning all that as well. And back to bounce. And then this one. So, I was asking Eva yesterday about the breathing.
Oh.
Now, Eva swears by natural breathing. She says the problem is if you start trying to do a specific type of breathing, she says she feels more tense. So she assumes other people get more tense when they're having to do a specific type of breathing. I mean, I think you can do it more tense, but you can actually be more relaxed if you have a specific kind of breathing.
Sometimes.
Oh, we've got a lot of fun. Brilliant. Hello, welcome. So it's more zoomies than roomies today, but never mind. We're the elite group, obviously. So yeah, I'll need to borrow you off. That very well volunteered. And I brought my book to take a register. So I'll just come in a bit. Yeah, the camera doesn't work here. The Wi-Fi is not strong enough and it flickers my camera. All the other places I use the camera and it doesn't flicker, it's very strange. But the microphone's very good on that camera, so I'll
get that going.
Oh, this is very relaxing music. I just fancy the music today. Okay. Now we
not having the radio, but you can hear it much clearer. As long as you're not all talking at once, then it messes it up. But if it's just one speaker, it's very, very good apparently. So you want to... Okay, we'll break this down a bit. So what you want to do is feel it go against the side of your body, and then that will come up by itself. Yeah, see? Then you're not having to do any excessive movement. It all is very energy efficient. Very energy efficient. And as well as being energy efficient movement, you cultivate energy. You give yourself, by doing lots of Tai Chi, you get more energy. It's like filling up. Shake it. I'll return that sort of tone. I don't know why it's on there. It was quiet before. I think each one, I like it as well, because I helped. I helped. I'm very pleased. So let's try that again. So we're breathing. Sink the hips. Let's just exaggerate it and then turn. Go up. Soft, smooth, and slow, and then down. Oh, that's marvellous. Okay, right, now what we're going to do is we're going to combine those and get this. So we're just a little bit quicker, a little bit quicker. Yeah, it's like your arms are really light then, aren't they? And they're falling down. Your arms just fall down into place. That's it, and you can feel your weight
we're all breathing.
I think the wind shut the door, didn't it? I'm gonna.
Could you open the window? Can you wind the thing? There's a white candle thing.
Yeah, because we've got to have the vents. I know there's only two of us, but we've still got to stick by the rules. The whole ventilation.
Yeah, I think we'll be okay.
Sure, we're all right. The breeze
blew it shut over. There's a big brick. Oh, you found the brick, did you? Oh, good. Right, I forgot what I'm doing. Now. I'm doing this. So you transfer the weight and turn. Try a bit quicker. Now, when you do something faster, relax more. So the faster you go, the more relaxed you need to be. Okay, now go super slow-mo. It's nice, isn't it? It's just, I quite like this. Like, you're not in a hurry. You're just taking a nice little leisurely walk. Okay, we could be here all day. Let's move on. That looks bad, everybody. So, sit down. Yeah, it's the wind keeps shutting. I'm going to shut it again. Yeah. Leave it, yeah. That's why it's shut. Never mind. We've got a window open. Must remember to shut the window, though, at the end.
Yeah.
So we just. Oh!
We need one of those sandwich boards.
Yeah. So I'm breathing. Oh, that's so much nicer. Open the hands, open the palms of the hands, which is nice and relaxed. So yeah, I was getting to do punching with Burwell. My intermediates, they love it. It's very funny. I videoed it, anyway, I'll show you on the... So you just want to really relax the shoulders, really relax the shoulders. Tall through the spine, you want to really lengthen. So that this bit suspends, you're floating up through here, and that means this stuff can all hang down. This stuff can all hang down. And then, wobbly. It's been very mild. We'll probably get a cold snap. I mean, because I'm playing at Triplo Daffodil Fest again, and we usually get, there was one year we got a cold snap, and it sometimes it will really, and then all the poor flowers will get frostbite. So, but we'll see, it might be alright, might be alright. Open the palms of the hands and relax your fingers, and feel the fingers hang. Now pay attention to the sensation of contact under your feet. Okay, a little shake out. So, foot exercises. What we're going to do, wiggle your toes. So, ever got us wiggling our toes in our, we were actually in bare feet, but those of you on Zoom, you might want to. And then press the toes down and lift the big toe up, and then press the big toe down and lift the other toes up. It's quite hard. And then the other thing is when you put your toes down, she said try and put them down one at a time. So try that out, because I
each toe down on its own. It's really good because it helps weight the feet up even if you can't do it. Okay, and then draw the toes in and stretch the toes out. Draw the toes in and stretch the toes out. Draw the toes in and stretch the toes out. So those of you that come on Friday for the fitness class, oh, I've got your email, I found it. I'll send you the link now when we finish.
Yeah.
Then if you want to come online, it's very good fun. I'm sort of... Because you already come to look at the classes, just come. Draw the toes in, stretch the toes out. And then we'll just go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So she tapped them 6, 7, 8. So she actually, when we did this with Eva, she said, tap your feet. Yeah, like you're in a mood. Yeah, like you're going, I want my dinner. You know. It's quite good. And then we'll do that one again. 1, 2. I wonder if you could go. Oh, you can. You do both.
You should have straight poles in there,
wouldn't you? Okay, right, that's enough of that. Cool, I can really feel that in my leg. Absolute nightmare. So the other horrible thing, what you can do at home if you're in bare feet, you can press your toes down and then you press, you've got us to press with the toes like that and the toes like that. You'll have to do that when you, and she sort of pressed behind and then pressed down and got, just sort of stretch, it stretches the ankle and it also does your toes at the same time. Because the toes, you often ignore those, and actually if you get your toes nice and mobile, it just has good effects on your walking and your balance, and your feet feel more alive. When I did, she spent ages on it. Okay, then you transfer the weight, cat stance, heel toe, transfer the weight, cat stance. So, yeah. Okay, now this time, transfer the weight in cat stance. Now, raise the knee so the foot hangs. Then you flex the ankle and you go heel, toe, transfer the weight, cat stance. Hang, flex, heel, toe, transfer, cat stance. Tall through the body. Nice and relaxed. Marvellous. Okay, and then for fun, you hold it for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you might need a wall next to you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think Emma's about 72-ish, or thereabouts, so she's got really big time into balancing, strengthening bone density, exercises that work bone density, which is one of them, and exercises that improve your cognitive function and your balance. She's really into those. Okay, just shake out. So, the other horrendous leg exercise you've got us to do is you've got us to do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And again, you might want to use a wall. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But we'll leave out the way. Give you next week. Oh, my goodness me.
Because we have
okay. Let me just try, just talk amongst yourselves, everybody. How did it go? Just like this.
today. Okay, let's do some, let's do some of this. So just breathe in.
Breathe out.
So I've had an update on Peng as well. We've got a new version of Peng spreads its wings. So we sink down. Sink down. So we come up and we breathe. And then now when you bring your hands down, actually keep going, I'll come a bit closer to the camera so you can see. So as I come up, you extend and open the hands. So you want to open but soften the hands. So like that. So you expect those of you on Zoom, now my head's vanished, but you're looking at the fingers anyway. And then we sink down. That's it. Up. And down. So her balance is actually excellent. She's got excellent balance and excellent bone density by doing all this Tai Chi type stuff. Sink down, open the palms of the hands. Relax around the jaw. Here and sometimes I'll have the hand like that.
There's no like rhyme or reason, they just sort of. We'll go back to Peng in a minute because Peng's useful for the really impossible silk reading that I can't do, but I'm going to try and do it together for fun. I've been trying to get it for ages, this. I think the best way of getting it is by trying to teach it, and then I'm sure it will work itself out or it'll explode, one or the other. But we want to relax. So, you know, when confronted with something tricky, you want to relax more. When you're doing a move faster, you want to relax more. That's the thing. And we're breathing naturally, breathing naturally. So you just want to feel everything is connected, the body is engaged. Oh, that wind's picked up. Guess we won't be outside for the next bit. We've got this nice wind floor, so. Okay, now what we do is go a bit quicker. Now remember, when you go faster, you relax. And don't worry so much about the body mechanics. You just do now a little bit, or just do a speeded up version, and then eventually you do this. In fact, let the arm relax, and then let it drop. This is a speeded up version of what I did with Carell yesterday. Now we try it again. So we start with some real slow-mo stuff. Really slow. So the idea, really relax, feel what it feels like to be moving in a relaxed manner, and then when we go faster, it can be very tempting to go, ooh, ooh, look, go. So you want to go, ugh. Relax even more. Really relax, nice and chilled. So whatever's going on that's affecting your state, you can relax. And we go a little bit quicker. And now it's just the elbow's not moving. Just the arm. So the elbow's staying where it is. Yeah, sorry, I forgot that bit. And then the wrist stays sort of still a bit more. And then you go a bit quicker. And then you let that arm go. Dum, dum, dum. And his arm became a blur when he did it. And then, oh, stop. Yeah. So, let's look at Pen. So what Eva does, she does a double wing. Now the Pen, this big mythological bird, Eva says that each spread of its wings covers half of the earth. That's how big you are. How cool is that? Each spread of its wings covers half the earth. So one side of planet Earth, the other side of planet Earth. And it's, yeah. Isn't that lovely? But we'll get to the Peng in a minute. Let's just get our arms a little bit more. Oh. Let's just do this. Oh, that's so nice. And we're just creating space in our body, getting nice and comfortable, so that we can relax even more. And then when something happens and you find yourself not relaxing, you can go, oh, I know what to do, I'm going to relax. And then the thing that's bothering you is less bothersome. It's just sort of softening around the edges a bit. And then that softening means you've got room to manoeuvre in an appropriate, correct manner. So you can deal with anything just by doing these exercises. So the Pen. We'll just do it one arm first. So we come. That's it. And we're all breathing. Three. We'll just do four each. Four. So imagine, I really like, now I know that these birds' wings are so big, they cover the whole earth. I don't know, it's just, now try it with the other arm. That's just wonderful. Don't you just love mythology? Isn't it great? So apparently the Peng's not just in China, there's a few different cultures that have the equivalent of the Peng. So it might even be one in Africa somewhere. You know, because this stuff all kind of recycles around the planet. One more time. Okay, right, now what we're going to do... Peng does backstroke. There we go, just try it out. Now if that's shoulders. And you want to turn your waist. You want to turn your waist. Show that from the... I find it very relaxing, this. I just think it's really nice. It's a big, beautiful, mythological bird. Okay, one more each side. And then what you can do is you can go for a pen walk. You can go for a pen walk. So it's different to white cranes. So you actually have the hand. You walk forwards like that. And then you can also walk backwards. You can go for a pen walk. So, one. So now I'm not so good at this, because I only did it yesterday. So, you know, you heard that song, Walks Like an Egyptian. This is Walks Like a Pen. But it's not quite got the right number of syllables, has it? Right, that's enough pen walking. I'll hopefully be able to pick it up a bit better. Let's just shake out. Oh, we've got a
message. Does that mean?
Yeah, the penguin might have caused the stormy weather. Yeah, maybe when it was flapping its wings around, it's blown the wind around. Yeah, I think you might have a point there. Brilliant. Oh, water break. Yeah, quick water break, and then we'll do nigh on impossible self-reading exercises. Woo! Which are all brilliant for the brain. So we're gonna exercise our cognitive function today. Yeah, the water's just in your kitchen if it's open. I'll put it open. Oh, that's so nice. So, okay, we'll start with pushing away the mountain. I would just demonstrate that. So that, like that, and like that. Oh, I better shut that because that would
hurt.
That's okay. It's a bit chilly out there. So, here we go. Now remember, if you're pushing a mountain away, you want to have really top-notch posture. Push away a mountain. So we come down like that. We, like this, palm out, palm. Oh, sorry, I'll come a bit closer. Like that. Then you come down. And then one comes in the front, and that's slightly straighter, and then you've got the bendy arm. Then you turn towards, hang on, one, two, three, yeah. You turn towards the straight arm, then you turn towards the bendy arm, you transfer your weight, and then you push away the mountain. Then you stroke down, then palm out like that, straight down. So it's like that. Don't worry about getting the detail just yet. Just do a vague thing that might be this move. And remember, if you find yourself getting tense, that you haven't quite, that you're doing a variation, what you really want to do is you want to relax more. You want to relax more. So you go one, two. I'm glad we're not outside. That weather's really changed, hasn't it? It was this beautiful sunny day. Three, four, five, push away the mountain, push. So you've got good posture, sink the hips, that's it, stroke down, three, four. So because you're doing all these turns and stuff with your arm, this is doing really useful things to your brain, and you push. It's a lot of turns. It's good for the brain, it's good for the body, it's good for your legs, it's good for your shoulders. It's good for looking really cool. There we go, look at that. Aren't we cool? Yeah. I can be cool, stop laughing at me. I'm very cool, you know. I'm the coolest person I know, I think. Yeah. And there we go, like that. You too can be cool, we'll be very cool. Because the thing is, when you don't care about what anyone else thinks, and you're just like in your chill zone all the time, of course you're the coolest person in the room. Just go stop after this one. We don't want to, you know, ruin it. But yeah, that was amazing. Shake out. Right. We'll do middle winding as a bit of... Right, now I've got to try and think. So they started like this. Have the hand like that. And then they transfer the weight, go like that. They transfer the weight, go like that. They transfer the weight, and then they transfer the weight. Boom. And then they go like this. One, two. This is a real vague approximation. I'm messing it up. Three, four. So four's quite good. So three's like your wind up, and then four's your release. Boom. So it's like a, yeah. And then you come up that side. Then you go this way, one, two, like you're driving a car, three, four. Then, is that right? No, that side, I can't remember. One, two, we'll just keep, I'll keep messing it up. Three, four, I've already done that side, never mind. And then five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two. This can only improve. We've got it. Three, four, five. One, two, three, four. I'm supposed to swap sides each time, but never mind. This is vaguely it. Just relax. Well, now we've changed sides. One, two, three. Something like that. Brilliant. That's better than it's ever been, but it's still not the final thing. Right, for fun, let's have a look at three circles. So this goes one, two, three, four, five, six. One. I'm doing it in super slow motion. Two, three, four, five. So if you find yourself, if your brain is starting to melt a bit, just relax, it's fine. You don't have to get this all right now in this instant. I mean, that last move we did, it's in there somewhere, I still don't know it. But I'll see him on Tuesday and it'll be better next Wednesday, so it's all... Little circle, little circle. Now we open, get this shape. Now you bring the hands together. So even if you just do this and then do that the other side, that's still a good thing. So your left hand underneath, your right hand on top. Turn towards your left, turn towards your right, turn towards your left. Separate the arms. Separate the arms. Stretch out. Now you do a little twizzle with that hand. Now you bring them back together. And it's all in the turning. Turn the waist. 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 So let's do this. That's better, isn't it? Oh. So, these are all from Xinjia, Xinjia Silk Reading. Xinjia's the new frame. Lao Zhi's about 300 years old, 350 years old, and Xinjia's only about 150 years old. So it's the baby form, but they've got these amazingly intricate, twizzly, roundy, silver really gets the sizes that are just great. Middle winding. First way. Like that. It goes one, two, three. This is a version. This is not the version. So there's lots of different variations. So you stretch, bring the hand towards, back. There we go. Keep breathing. Keep relaxed. So you just want to relax. Whatever it is you're doing, even if you're doing a variation that's maybe not quite what I'm doing, you just want to relax. I'll show you that from the side, the back. Soften the arms, soften and relax. And eventually, through repetition, you'll get the move. You know, maybe in like a decade or something, you'll get the move and it'll be perfect. But you just want to. Okay, let's go back to this one. Oh, isn't that easy? Look at that. Aren't we good? Aren't we brilliant? Look at that. You see, so you do all this complicated stuff and then you can do this and it feels great. Amazing. Oh, what a relief.
Like some greener on the skin.
Yeah, it's like when you're on the flat bit. Oh. And then we just, Right, what was the other move? Oh yeah, let's do another leg merging exercise after this, missus. And we've got a silly exercise. Yeah, we'll do the silly one. Okay, now go in the other direction. Nice. So you want to relax, basically. You want to relax and you want to notice stuff. You want to sense what you can hear, what you feel. Sense how you're feeling. So whatever emotional state you are, just think, try and find the still bit inside and just sort of be in there. Oh, the sun's coming. Ooh, sunshine. Right, let's go the other side. Ah, marvellous. Okay, and then we just go, Oh, that's so relaxing. Do you know, I feel really relaxed just watching you, Mum. I feel really chilled out. Thank you. That's amazing. Okay. Nice and relaxed. Now we change directions. Change directions. So. Keep breathing. Nice. It's lovely, isn't it? Very good. Okay, shake out. So, Monkey King takes a seat. So, I'll show you that from the diagonal view. You take a slightly wider, what Eva did yesterday was she took a wider, not huge wide start, but definitely wider than Wu Qi start. And then what you're doing is you're counterbalancing. So your hips sink back and your hands project forwards. And then you come back. Now, you can do a baby monkey king and that's perfectly fine. And I'm lengthening through, so I'm folding here but I'm lengthening through my spine. And that's a really good way of building up these muscles in your legs. Now, if you want, and if your knees can take it, you can go all the way down to a squat and then come back up. What fun! So for fun, my fun, you can go down. Now make sure you can get back up again without having to call an ambulance. Isn't this character building? I'm feeling my character building as we speak.
Practice that one.
Yeah, So you sit on your throne and then you survey your beautiful kingdom of Reach.
Actually,
it is beautiful. It's a very beautiful village.
The Queen was here,
wasn't
she?
The Queen was here? Ooh.
What did
she think of it?
The Queen of the Anglo-Saxons.
Oh! Bodicea was here. Boudicca.
Cool!
Olden.
She,
the original Queen of the Anglo-Saxons, visited Reach.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, there you go. There you go. Brilliant. Okay. Shake it out. No, I still can't do it. Never mind. Okay. Let's just do this. Right. Love us into a full sense of security. Then, for the next 10 minutes, we'll have a look. We'll have a look at the health version of why take off is fruit. Because we've done phoenixes, we've done tigers, we've done... let's do the phoenix. That's a very good one for the neck, actually. Okay, demonstration. We'll do the simplified, simplified version. So you touch your arms together, and then you find the little finger finds the elbow, and then that turn, and then you bring the hand back. Then you make a round shape. Then you turn and turn. And that's the phoenix, and then we come back, reach, round shape, turn, and then you can look down. So it's called Phoenix Turns Its Head. So we've gone from one mythological bird to the other, and there's footwork with it as well. So, but we'll just get the arm shape first. So it's bendy arms. Looks a bit like Egyptian hieroglyphs when you see them doing that stuff. So what you do, you turn your foot, you transfer the weight, you turn your foot, then you lean slightly. So you're kind of like slightly imposing and get your tiger eyes. Then you sink back, you turn. You transfer, you sink the weight, you turn your foot, so they're kind of parallel, and then you lean, and then you look behind, then you come back. And look behind. Then we put that all together and it magically transforms into this beautiful harmonious thing of elegance. No pressure. Remember, if you feel pressure, relax. That's it.
Do you look down both sides?
Yeah, you've got the effect. Now transfer your weight, turn the foot, little finger to the elbow, round shape. Round shape first, then you turn, look down. Then you come back. Little finger on the elbow. Get yourself in position first. Eventually, this sort of sorts itself out. Phoenix turns its head. Phoenix turns its head. So you want to keep both arms bent. So that's bendy and that's bendy, and then you look down. That's what she was very adamant about that ever yesterday. Well, I've got this move okay. I just can't get that so really. Okay, and then come back. Go into cat stance, hold the ball. Step out. Transfer the weight, part the wild horse's mane. Keep the weight in the front foot open, close, sink back, fanning out, dragon holds the puddle, so we've got a dragon. time. So just really relax. Doesn't, you know. So Tai Chi Chuan doesn't need to be something else you're getting uptight about. That's kind of not how we work. So whatever it is you're doing, just feel connected, feel calm, and you know when you're not doing it correctly, but just relax and move as best you can. In it's more about how you're moving, and it's okay. So you can do why take office fruit as a little walking exercise. I'll go back a bit, so I can fit more of the in. And what we're gonna do, actually, if you come back in, so we're gonna go for walkies. So, how to walk around the village. So you might be in the shops, and then you just go for a walk, and then you just, oh. So we're doing what we've just done, but step, two, three, four, five, white, eight, office fruit, six, seven, one, two, three, four, five, circle, everybody. Don't know how that works on Zoom, but so just breathing. Breathe out. So playing around with speeds, whatever speed you're at, you relax. So when you're going really slowly, relax more. When you go really fast, relax more. If your neighbours are being annoying, relax. Check your alignment, relax. Whatever it is you're doing, that is the answer. You know, sink your hips, relax, breathe. Deal with it. Whatever's going on. Your boiler's exploded, relax. There's a plague on and all the electrics have gone up. Everything's expensive, just relax.
Just go out for a walk and it'll warm you up. Don't get heat on.
Yeah, I'll put on candles. You know, we can get. And then sun and moon. That's the phantom loo. The loo in this place, it makes weird swishy noises. It sounds a bit like a cappuccino machine, doesn't it? You know, except you wouldn't want.
It's
very strange. Very strange. Embrace the tiger. Return to the mountain. I suspect we might even finish on time for a change. That'd be unusual.
I like the phoenix.
The phoenix is nice, isn't it? It's very good for the neck and very good for confusing the brain. It does all these amazing things. Okay, open the palms a bit more. Really relax the palms, relax the wrists. Do one more and then we better have very extra young faces. faces, I reckon, so... Ooh, I've got the afternoon off.
Yay!
Yeah. How exciting! So check your posture, feel the ground under your feet, wiggle the toes a bit and then draw the toes in, relax the ankles, relax the knees, sink the hips, lengthen through the spine, take a few slow deep breaths. Left hand over the top. Bring your feet together.